Today I'm continuing all the finish work on my subwoofer enclosure. So far, this simple design has been a lot of fun to slap together real quick. Russell Francis says I could have saved a lot of time if I would have done all of this work before I closed the box up. And then he called my box a midget disco. Inside. Apparently, Russell Francis doesn't realize the importance of the test phase. He's an old customer, I didn't test his box. I slapped it together, threw it in his trunk, charged him full price, and sent him on his way. Now he's leaving comments on my YouTube channel because I won't return his calls. Apparently his expensive box fell apart. Which is why I want to test mine. I don't want a shitty box like his. This is for my car, of course I'm gonna... Amplifiers produced by Soundman Enterprises Inc., Mobile Solutions, CT Sounds, and Extreme Auto Sports. Right now I'm going to mount the urethane slats onto the bottom of the box. I'm going to cut a couple countersunk holes in the sliders on the CNC router, so before I pull the cork material off, I'm just going to run a second window gasket. I figure if I cut a spare window gasket now, I'll never have to pull the window back off. But if I only have one, the cork will evaporate. If you have it, you never need it, but if you need it, you never have it. But if you don't have it, the cork will evaporate.
Shut the fuck up, Doug. Jesus Christ.
While I'm doing this, I'm going to go ahead and predict some future comments. Russell is going to ask, why in the world did you use the CNC router to drill the holes? You could have saved a lot of time if you just used a drill bit. It does take some time to program the holes in the software, but it'll be worth it in the end. I can keep my drill bit clean for when I run it up Russell's asshole. It'll be worth it in his end if he doesn't shut the fuck up. You're pissing me off again, and this is only a comment prediction. What Russell doesn't understand is that it's not about how fast it is to drill a goddamn hole, it's about perfect and exact and consistent hole placement and depth. If I was worried about how long it would take, this would look like the box I built for your car, Russell. Shitty. Program is done, now we could find out what happens when you cut urethane on a CNC router. I think you could do it. I never CNC cut urethane before. One guy said you couldn't do it. Said it would melt the urethane. Stink up the shop, smell like a goddamn nail salon in here. Rafa's mom might smell it and try to come over for a pedicure. I'll have to back the mule out to pull her goddamn right foot into the shop. I don't have enough paint for that shit.
Why don't you shut the fuck up right now, seriously?
I don't have that kind of sandpaper.
Are you done so you can shut the...
One guy said it's gonna gum up the bit, grab the urethane, yank it, spin it off the table, fling it across the shop, knock over the gas can. Work fine. What the fuck is that? Now I have perfectly even and symmetrical countersunk holes at the appropriate depths. Fucking goddamn it. Did it again. I mean, goddamn, look at those depths.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
Now I'm going to insert my nuts into the box, then I'll be able to bolt the slats on. Now I need to be super careful not to drill all the way through the bottom. These insert nuts are 1/2 inch deep, and the bottom is only 3/4 inch thick. One wrong slip in the... That means it's not authentic. I'm marking the hole placement with a small bit and then going 1/2 inch deep with the next size up. Oh, if I fuck up now and drill just slightly too deep, I'll poke through the other side. I'll have to start over, which is impossible. I don't have the blueprints anymore. The government confiscated the designs, said it was alien technology. I drew them with shit on a piece of toilet paper. They still took them, even though the designs really stink. They took the box too. Good thing I secretly built a second one. Because I have so much time on my hands because of the schedule change and all. Spoiler alert, I popped through the other fucking side. Just kidding. Nailed it again. These nuts are great. Having a threaded nut embedded into the surface of my wood makes for a perfect solution to mount the urethane sliders. If you would like some of these nuts, ask your local Home Depot associate for embeddable chin nuts. If he can't help you, have your mom swing by my shop. I have plenty of nuts for her chin. If she pays extra, I could install these nuts into the bottom of her box. Son of a slat birch. Hand wielding a masterpiece may feel never ending. I'm talking about my dick again. May feel never ending, but it's worth it in your end. You know what I mean? Now I have a good way to mount the slats to the box. Should we cut a corkboard gasket for the urethane sliders?
No.
Now I'm going to start working on weatherproofing the removable hatch door. This piece needs to be painted and weatherproofed, so I need to take the steel frame off of the wood plate, clean it up, sandblast the steel frame, paint it, sand the wood down, primer that, and paint that too. Russell might say, the frame wouldn't have rusted if you would have painted it in the first place. But what Russell doesn't understand is that if I would have known that this box was going to sound so good in the first place on the first try, I would have taken it directly to the Guinness World Record Museum. This is the internet box build to receive the most advice from people who have never built a box before. It's a goddamn world record. I got Mark from the Fab Kitchen leaving comments giving me port advice, yet he's never built a sixth order bandpass in his life. He's new. He's over there designing boxes in his kitchen with dog food and graph paper. What the fuck does he know?
And somehow add more dog food to this pile to fill in down here to get more loud, low.
His old ass just started his first pair of A-pillar speaker pods. Just now. I did my first A-pillar pods when I was 9.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
The frame is sandblasted, now I'm gonna clean it up, hit it with some paint, then I'll sand down the hatch door, primer that, then paint that too. Both of these pieces have been thoroughly cleaned and I air blew them dry. Now I'm going to hit them with a light tack coat and then go back over them till they're thoroughly covered. Sanding the surface, cleaning it really well, air blowing it dry, then applying a tack coat before you apply a thick coat is a critical step to ensure that Russell shuts the fuck up. Yuan leaving dumb comments telling you how to paint. Some of the people that leave comments seem constipated. And they're acting like it's my fault. It's a shitty thing to say, Russell.
Wait, you like the mic, a G, so I use my voice. As soon as the comes, it's the beat Rolls Royce. This.
I'm happy with the way this turned out. My next obstacles are to cut a new window and to come up with a way to mount the stainless steel top. Thank you guys so much for watching. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think about today's video. I'll see you guys next time. Support Amplified by buying iPad dash kits and Soundman merch at soundmanca.com. Become a car audio master with the tools and trainings available for mobile solutions at mobilesolutions-usa.com. Receive a discount on all the best car audio equipment from CT Sounds by using coupon code SOUNDMAN at ctsounds.com. And come down to see me and Rafa at Extreme Autosports in Santa Clarita and get great deals on audio and performance equipment and installations.